fundador de Arm Crowd de Israel, una combinación entre un fondo de inversión y una red de inversionistas ángeles que ha hecho más de 220 inversiones y ha generado más de 40 éxitos desde su lanzamiento en el año 2013. Las empresas de su portafolio han sido vendidas a compañías como Uber, Oracle, Intel, entre otras. Así que estamos súper contentos de darle la bienvenida a John. Él va a hacer su presentación en inglés, pero ya les hemos indicado que tenemos la posibilidad entonces de traducción simultánea. Nice to meet you, John. Welcome.
Nice to be here. Bienvenidos en hola a Chile and todo el Latam. I'm going to speak in English so you don't have to suffer my actual Spanish.
Yeah, no problem. Thank you so much for your time.
I'm delighted to be here. You hear me okay and see me okay?
Yeah.
Wonderful. Okay. Let's get started. You can see my slides. Look, I want to talk to you today about venture capital and about democratizing venture capital and about how AI is changing everything all over the world. You guys all know that today's big money is being made in technology companies. But in the old days, you could have participated by buying these stocks when they went public with an IPO. Today, unfortunately, you're only invited once these companies are huge. So while you could have made 2,000 times your money back in the day when Amazon or Microsoft or Apple went public, today you're left with very, very small potential returns in the market. The people who are making the money are the private investors. And that's why the head of the SEC said, we must democratize access into venture capital for investors all over the world. Now, this is true, by the way, in the US, it's true in Israel, where I live, but it's also true in Chile. How do you invest in a hot startup in Israel or in Silicon Valley? And the answer is, it's hard until there are platforms. Why would you like to invest? Well, people who are smart money like Yale University are deploying literally over 20% of their endowment to venture capital because they understand how important that is for returns. And you look at what's happened in terms of venture capital funding, it's gone up through the roof, about $300 billion last year. There are now almost 600 unicorns. It used to be that a unicorn was a rare animal, but we now have hundreds of them. These, of course, are the companies that are already worth $1 billion, but have not gone public. So we set up our crowd to basically take advantage of this so that people around the world could start by investing in Israeli startups, but ultimately in startups all over the world. Now, Israel is a really interesting tech ecosystem. Today, rated by the World Economic Forum at number one in terms of entrepreneurial culture, growth of innovative companies, and a bunch of other key areas. You look at what's happened in terms of fundraising. This past year, actually, the full year is in, $10 billion invested in Israeli high-tech venture capital. That's up from $8 billion last year, 25% growth in a year of COVID. And the exits are also incredible. Actually over $100 billion in the past decade and up at the $20 billion level. What's happened is we're starting to build companies of great critical mass so that you're no longer selling companies for $100 or $200 million, but you're selling them for billions of dollars. And this is now moving into higher gear because Israel has just signed deals with its neighbors in the Gulf. And this is going to bring huge amounts of capital and new exciting opportunities for Israel to work with the larger Arab and Islamic world and to open up markets in a brand new way. Now, we actually just hired a new head of our operation down in the Gulf ourselves. What do? We are the most active venture investor in Israel, and we do this on a democratic basis. We have over $1.5 billion already invested. Actually, our number of investors worldwide are over 60,000, and we have a portfolio of over 200 companies. We are, by the way, the most active AI investor in Israel. Last year, we made 38 new company investments in Israel and around the world. We provide our investors with both individual companies or funds that they can invest in. And again, we have 60,000 of the individuals together with many hundreds of institutions. We actually now are approaching 65,000 total investors. It's quite a huge platform. And again, we give you the opportunity to invest in funds or selecting your own investments. And this is what our portfolio looks like in terms of the number of companies that we have. And the Israeli tech ecosystem consists of thousands of investors, thousands of entrepreneurs, literally over 100 today, VC funds, tech units in the army, and then hundreds of multinationals and incubators who are fanning this system. So let's look at AI specifically in Israel. It turns out that Israel is now number 3 in the world in terms of AI startups, almost neck to neck with China. China has 383, Israel has 362. This is a little bit older data, but I think it's essentially still correct. And our crowd, according to Forbes, is the most active investor in AI startups in Israel. This is what it looks like. If you try to track all these companies, you'll see that there are AI startups just in Israel that are in automotive and industrial and healthcare and fintech and marketing. They're all over the place in a variety of different areas. And we all know that AI sits at the middle of many, many trends that are moving forward and fast. And whether it's 5G or the next, you know, GPUs, cloud resources, big data, and IoT, AI is at the heart of all of this. And many of our AI companies, which I'm going to talk about in a second, are busy raising money even during the pandemic. One of the wild things about this year is we thought the world was coming to an end. It didn't. The whole tech economy actually accelerated. Look at the stock prices of Apple, Google, Tesla, and others, but also look at the money being raised by companies that are leading the way in digital transformation. It was Satya Nadella from Microsoft who said that this year, each month represented a year of digital transformation. And this is being driven a lot by the AI revolution. And of course, we're using this to actually fight the COVID pandemic. And this is good news for everybody's health. A lot of our companies now are becoming very, very well valued. We have actually over 60 companies that are valued over $100 million. So we're not your normal crowdfunding site because our companies are doing very well. In fact, this is an old slide. We have 46 exits so far. And these are companies that are exiting on the New York, mostly New York Stock Exchange or NASDAQ, or being bought by huge multinational companies. And what's amazing, actually, is that last year in 2019, I'm sorry, the year before last, we had the best IPO on Wall Street, which is called Beyond Meat, was one of our companies. And in 2020, the best IPO was our company Lemonade, which uses AI to totally disrupt the insurance company. So let's go look at the ways that AI and our companies are innovating in so many different areas, whether it's healthcare or ag tech, logistics, mobility, cybersecurity, energy. It's having an impact everywhere. And in fact, if you look at our portfolio, in the last 5 years, Fast Company puts together their list of the most innovative companies, and we've had 20 of our companies on this list worldwide, which we're very proud of. So in the fintech area, I mentioned Lemonade. This is a company which is just changing the way that insurance is being done. I haven't looked at the stock price today, but it's about $9 billion or so of market cap. This is just a couple of year old startup that was founded by my dear friend, Daniel Schreiber, And it's just an amazing company, not yet selling in Latin America. But if I was in the insurance business anywhere in the world, I would be watching what Lemonade is doing. BioCatch is another amazing AI company using behavioral biometrics. What they do is they actually can track who you are by how you hold your phone or touch your phone. Would you believe that every person on the planet has an individual signature? And they're using this to fight fraud very, very effectively. In the cybersecurity area, companies like ThetaRay are using AI to protect against fraud. Right now, they're focusing on essentially correspondent bank transfers. There's a ton in fintech of AI that's being used. And we have a variety of other wonderful companies, obviously, in the cybersecurity area. Israel's very, very strong. In mobility, Israel, of course, you know, so the company Mobileye was sold to Intel for $15 billion, and they were using rules-based. But we have a company called Kartika, which is actually using an autonomous self-learning AI that is actually helping the next generation of autonomous cars, but also in the current generation of ADAS or collision avoidance systems. Very exciting company indeed. In healthcare, tons of activity going on in healthcare. Perhaps the most striking company we have in AI is a company called Zebra Medical. What Zebra does is uses AI to help radiologists interpret radiological images. And they've got already, I think, 7 different modalities now approved by the FDA. And more to come. It's being deployed in hospitals around the world. Big OEM deal with Johnson & Johnson, and a very exciting company. In agriculture, you would be shocked at how important AI is. And whether it's companies like Taranis that are collecting incredible amounts of data from very, very interesting visual or essentially imaging pickups from fast flying, crop dusters. They can actually tell the sex of a bug, you know, from a plane flying at 200 miles per hour. That drone from Tevel is actually being used to pick fruit. You have drones that are now doing fruit picking, and we hope to bring that technology soon to Chile. Or companies like CropX, who are using a drill-in sensor in the ground, do-it-yourself, that hooks up to the cloud and then provides tremendous data so you can get information on how to irrigate and how to fertilize your fields. In the areas of energy, companies like Emprest, who are building what's called distributed energy resource management systems, because today's electrical grids need to be essentially real networks, because you've got renewable energy and you've got batteries and you've got, you know, all kind of EVs, and you need to have a much more flexible network than we used to have. This company actually got its start with Israel's Iron Dome project, the anti-missile project, which Empress developed the software for, and a variety of other exciting energy companies. In the AI area itself specifically, you have companies like Halo, who are making the most exciting AI accelerator chip, which is essentially a GPU for AI processing that works, 30 times faster and uses much less energy, especially for the edge, where you want to start doing this processing at the edge. Companies like Citru, which is using AI to do automated baggage screening and now actually being used in logistics for freight, okay, by instead of having a low-paid, security personnel person trying to understand what's in your bag, we get the AI do that. And then an amazing company called Metaware, who are essentially looking at what you're being prescribed in terms of drugs in the hospitals. Today, They found in a Harvard study that not only can we save the health system millions of dollars, but save lives, because so many mistakes are made by what drugs you're being prescribed. AI can save those lives. We've been doing some amazing funding in companies like Sight Diagnostics, which is using AI to do a full CBC or complete blood count, okay, which basically is giving you in 10 minutes in a little desktop with two drops of blood. And you might say, wait a minute, I heard about that company. Wasn't there a company called Theranos that was a fraud? And the answer is yes, this is a different company. This is an Israeli company which actually works. It's got FDA clearance and is using AI to do blood analysis. So we mentioned earlier this company, Tevel. You can see the sort of animation, I hope, on your screen of how it actually works. But this is real. You can send a swarm of these drones into your fields and all of your fruit gets picked even at night, okay, believe it or not. Trellis is using AI to help big food producers, including some big producers of wine in Chile, believe it or not, to optimize their supply chain so that they can spend less money and deliver quicker and better results. And it's spectacular AI for supply chain optimization in food. We talked about Taranis before, and we talked about CropX. We didn't talk about Consumer Physics, who are basically using the world's smallest spectrometer, which they invented, to give you real-time data at the farm level, at the corn level, to tell you how much moisture is in that corn, to tell you how much protein is in soybeans, or how much moisture is in animal feed. And this allows essentially you to do big data analysis and optimization for farms like never before. And that company is called Consumer Physics. In the medical area, we have a variety of companies. Most importantly, perhaps, is Taito, who are using this incredible set of small tools that go home with you. And then at 2 o'clock in the morning, when your child starts screaming and saying, my ear hurts, you don't have to take them to the hospital. You can actually get clinical grade images. It gets sent to a doctor or an AI, which then does the analysis. This was used here in Israel and is still being used during the COVID outbreak to provide remote diagnosis, both in ears, nose, mouth, lungs, heart. Remarkable stuff and growing fast. MeMed is using AI to determine literally within 15 minutes whether what is causing your infection is either a virus or bacteria. Today, we have really no easy ways to determine that. And this is a brand new breakthrough, a spectacular company. You'll be hearing a lot about this one. Sweech is using AI to manage chronic diseases, because today, you know, the most important medical device is your phone, and you can use your phone, has been proven clinically, to provide better outcomes in terms of disease management. Cryon is in the area of RPA, which is robotic process automation, where instead of having humans do the coding, you bring in the bots. And actually, they were very helpful during COVID when people needed to all of a sudden hook up enormous numbers of PCR tests into the real-time data network of health organizations. And these guys did it literally in 2 days. We mentioned Halo before. This company is, by the way, doing very well. Just raised $60 million in their Series B for their AI chips. And that's the actual size of their accelerator. We also mentioned Sight, also raised $71 million for that blood analyzer. And finally, Sense Education, which is using AI to get better test results. So you can actually not just do online a true or false or multiple choice, but you can actually use the AI to understand unstructured data, such as coding in a computer science class or even essay questions. So our companies are making a lot of news. You'll see them all the time in a variety of newspapers around the world. We invite you to come next year when we have this event back in person. This year in 2020, or last year, I guess, since we're already in 2021, we had 23,000 people register for this event. It's the biggest event of its kind worldwide. We'd love to see many of our friends from Chile come and work with us. And I think that, you know, now we're doing a lot of events in virtual. We'd like to invite you. We're working very closely, by the way, with AMM in Chile on distributing some of our fund products. And we're very interested in building a bigger presence in the Chilean and the Latin American market. I think with that, I'm going to stop my sharing, and I'll be happy to answer some questions or have a dialogue with the rest of the group. And I'm not hearing you. I'm not hearing the questions. I'm not hearing my questions.
Sole, estás en mute.
Okay.
Sorry, John, sorry. Perdón, tenía mi micrófono muteado. Bueno, a todos nos ha pasado y a mí ahora por primera vez en la conducción de un evento. Iván, thank you, John, for your presentation.
By the way, yo siento, Iván, it must have been very hard to translate me. Because I was speaking.
Yeah, a minute, please, a minute. Porque tenemos una pregunta para él que se repite, Iván, también acá. ¿Qué necesita Chile, ¿no?, y Latinoamérica en general para transformarse en una startup nation? Tal como lo hizo Israel y tal como los casos que nos ha presentado él con estupendos ejemplos, además, varios de ellos relacionados con el momento que estamos viviendo.
La pregunta es para John, ¿cierto?
Sí.
Sí.
¿Se la puedes traducir tú?
Ok. John,
yo entiendo. It was basically
I was speaking in I was speaking in English with you.
Okay.
Somebody asks, what does a country like Chile or other countries in Latin America to walk the path that has been walked by Israel? What are the main ingredients? What is the secret sauce of Israel to have such a huge amount of success stories in startups and investments?
I think that the answer is about comunidad. And the problem is that Latin America as a whole is this, you know, great 700 million people, many countries, but each country is really its own little community. And I don't think we've seen in the startup area enough of a continent-wide activity. So, you know, there have been some great startups out of Latin America, like Rappi and others, okay? But they're, you know, very few organizations that are all about LATAM, okay? And that bring capital together. So, for example, the amount of money which is being invested in LATAM at the moment is about one half the amount of money which is being invested in Israel. That's okay, right? I guess, except LATAM has 700 million people and Israel has 9 million. Okay.
Okay. May I translate? Sole, ¿quieres que traduzca al castellano?
No, porque teníamos nuestra traducción, así es que ya se ha escuchado también la respuesta en español.
Okay.
Iván, para gestionarle mejor la pregunta que yo en inglés. John, thank you for your time. Nice to meet you.
Thank you, John. Impressive your track records.
Hasta luego. And I look forward to being back with you soon in la futura. Gracias a todos.
Okay.
Bye-bye.